When I'm hungry, then this is a problem from the perspective of Six Sigma. My saturation level is too low. But of course, I would not collect data or conduct a workshop on this routine problem, because the solution is obvious. Eat. For intransparent and complex problems, however, Six Sigma is superior to all other methods, because it is based on a scientific approach. Imagine that you have observed the finished cookies in the bakery and detected a difference in their attribute color, from pale to beige to brown to black. You also observed that the baking times on the timer were set differently. And now you relate the baking time and the cookie color chronologically. This is the basis of every scientific observation. Differences in an attribute of similar objects, such as the color of cookies, and relationships to the attribute of another object, such as the baking time on the timer, as well as the direction of the influence of X on Y. Sure, we do that every day. These observations on differences and relationships are now represented as assumptions in the presented process model. The cookies and their variable color as output, Y, and the timer with the baking times as influencing resource, XR. Perhaps supplemented by observations on the oven and its baking temperature, also XR. As in natural science, we would now formulate the assumed relationships between the X's and Y as statistical hypotheses, as well as hypotheses on the differences within the variable Y. Then we would collect data not only for one cookie and its baking time and baking temperature, but for a whole sample. And if our observation is more than a random finding, then the assumed relationships and differences are confirmed by statistical tests. And this confirmation, together with the model, helps us not only to describe the reality, but also to explain and predict it. The equation y is a function of x thus becomes the core of Six Sigma. X and y, i.e. cause and problem, are observed in reality via differences and relationships. They are translated into the model as assumptions and operationalized as measurement variables. Statistical tests on the collected data then confirm or reject the observations of our reality. This method is mapped in the first three phases, define, measure, analyze, of the DMAIC cycle and concretized by associated tools. In the define phase, we define the problems of the output and their effects, for example, the financial potential. In this phase, we typically decide on the implementation of the project and organize the project. In the measure phase, we identify the triggering influences from the process, evaluate the strength of the relationships between the problems and the influences by experts, formulate these assumptions as statistical hypotheses, and collect related data. In the analyze phase, we then statistically test the hypotheses on X and Y, and search for the root causes of the triggering influences. And these root causes are the interface for solutions. In the improve phase, we search for solution ideas and implement related measures to eliminate, adjust, or circumvent the root causes. In the final control phase, we statistically check our success by before-after comparisons, derive the financial benefits, and ensure the sustainability of the operational excellence we have achieved. Now please go to Gemba, observe outputs and how their value is created. This can be in any repeated workflow. Take pictures, in real or screenshots. Identify intermediate and final outputs, their attributes and the deviations from the requirements. Search for positive and negative influences in inputs, activities, methods and resources.